Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep. This video series is talking about interference curve analysis for the advanced segment. In our previous video, we talked about how price effect is a combination of income effect and substitution effect. In this video, we shall take a look at how we can derive the demand curve for normal goods under the indifference curve analysis. So without wasting any time further, let's get started. So just to let you know, we are going to derive the demand curve for normal goods through price effect. Now in this case, good X, which is measured on the X-axis, is a normal good. We have good Y on the Y-axis, and we have the initial budget line, which is AB, the initial indifference curve IC, and the equilibrium at point E. At point E, this consumer is consuming OX quantity of commodity X. Now, let us suppose that the price of commodity X falls. By now, we should be aware that the budget line would rotate outwards, right? So, let's draw the budget line. So, the new budget line now is AB1. Now, we need to remember that since the price of commodity X has gone down, this commodity is now relatively cheaper. That means the consumer will be able to buy more of this commodity, more of good X. And in that case, let us say the consumer is on this particular equilibrium. Let me just draw the IC curve first. So let us say the consumer is now on this IC curve, which is IC1, point of equilibrium is E1. And at point E1, the consumer is now consuming, let us say, OX1 quantity of good X. From our previous videos, we should be knowing that when we join these two equilibrium pointers, we get the PCC curve, which is the price consumption curve. Now, this video was focusing on derivation of the demand curve. Let us try and see how the demand curve could be derived from this particular scenario. All right. Now, let's plot the first scenario where the consumer is consuming OX quantity of good X. Let me just bring this down quantity from here to here. All right. So, I will just stretch this down. Let us say the consumer is consuming OX quantity of good X, and let us suppose, since we do not have the numericals for price, we are assuming that the price is here at P. Now, what did we assume? We assumed that the price for commodity X is falling, and because of that, the consumer increased his consumption to OX1. Let us bring down the quantity OX1 in our lower panel. So, I'm just going to put some dots here, and from here a solid line. Alright. So, this is OX1, and we know that there was a fall in price. So, let us say the fall could be depicted somewhere around here. Let us say the price fell to P1. So, when the price fell to P1, the consumer increased his quantity of good X to X1. Joining these two pointers, we get a demand curve, which is a downward sloping curve. This is how we will be able to derive a demand curve for normal goods under indifference curve analysis approach. Now, we need to remember that for normal goods, the demand curve is a downward sloping curve. And we also remember from our previous videos that price effect in case of normal goods is always negative. All those students who do not understand price effect, please take a look at the videos for PCC and price effect before you come on to this video. All right? Students, if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel and share my videos with your friends. If you do not find learning from big videos, long videos, you can also follow my Instagram channel where you would find most of this content in the reel format and you'll be able to learn in a much shorter duration. I'll be releasing the notes for the diminishing marginal utility by the end of this week. So stay tuned for the posts that I make on my YouTube channel. And do not forget to follow me on my Facebook page because that's the place where I'll be releasing the notes. Alright, I'll meet you in another video with another topic. Bye now. Take care.